Hello, welcome to the video. So this is Tap Ninja, and you are this ninja, and you kill the incoming enemies that run, well, they're pretty much only standing here, and you run past them and kill them. This is your main source of income, and you can click that, get a bunch of achievements. So we have this farm, sawmill, mine, tavern, blacksmith, and barracks. And this is the research. I'm currently on tier 3. This one increases the passive income. And I think this one, every time I kill an enemy, coins fly out. As you can see, this one gives more enemies. This one increases passive income. This one, more money. Here is a new enemy, carried the armor. I think we entered a new world. I'm not sure if it's based on game time or maybe your income, or your research, or how much money you have or something like that. I think this is a new enemy. Spearmen drop more money. Not sure who the spearmen are. This one had nothing interesting. Here's the shield bearer. Oh, it says right there when you unlock an enemy. Yeah, so this one unlocked the spearmen. Nothing interesting in that one. Nothing interesting there. There are achievements, lots of them. I have 17 out of 398 and gives me 170 extra income. I think this is the reset function. This is worth it, it says. We can watch an ad for 5 amber. And considering the cheapest one is 150, that doesn't really feel like that good value. So visually, this game is pretty similar to Idle Slayer. No one can deny that. In Idle Slayer, you're also a guy that runs around killing enemies exactly like this. But you can jump in Idle Slayer, you cannot jump here. And there are no Mario boxes to slam your head against. So let's try to ascend. We lose all our buildings, unfortunately. Let's spend one to buy that one. Increase base value by 400%. That sounds pretty good. More passive income. This tree is actually really big. So if we check it out, we can see it's has a lot of stuff. We can randomly click various things. It's mainly just making more money. And the last upgrade is here. Buildings cost 10% less and upgrades 10% cheaper. With that, we can buy a bunch of buildings again. Once you fill this up, you gain more money from them. I think it was like times 2. Yeah, times 2 money. And all the research reset. That's gonna be pretty annoying to deal with. But after a few of these ascensions, that would probably not be too much of an issue. This one gives more enemies. The offline income works for 12 hours. I'm not sure if they have something to extend the time itself. Unlock energy ability. Destroy enemies automatically for a time. That's pretty good. Because if you're not using a clicker, actually killing all enemies is kind of annoying. Unlock rope hook ability. Not sure what that can do. If you liked Idle Slayer, maybe check this out. If you didn't like Idle Slayer, then maybe check this out anyway, because it's not exactly the same, only pretty similar. In Idle Slayer, you make money from buying gear. Here you buy it from buying these houses, these buildings. There we go. Tier 1 upgraded, or research maybe. But yeah, I think I'm gonna call it here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.